Have you ever been trying to build a little circuit on some of these breadboards and you try to get your resistors in there and they just don't ever seem to go and you just wind up with these crazy squiggly legs that are all scrunched up? Well, the problem is not yours, my friend. The problem is either these wimpy resistor leads. I call them angel hair leads because they're so thin, or you've unfortunately gotten a bad breadboard, and I'm going to talk about both of those in this video. First of all, let's talk about these wimpy resistors. I hate these things. These leads are so skinny, they just don't hold up, and that's what most vendors are selling these days. Let me show you the difference here. Actually, let's take a look at some close up here. There's skinny and there's some skinny leads and some fat leads, and you can visually see the difference. And those fat leads are what used to be the norm. I've been playing around with electronics for 40 years, and back in the day, that's all we had was these fat leads. And now with all these Chinese vendors now trying to do everything cheap, all we're getting now is these skinny leads. Let's take a look at the difference. There's a big difference in these leads, and so it's not your fault that you're getting all these scrunched up leads. Let's take a look at the angel hair leads, because those are the first ones I talked about. I've got a nice digital caliper here. Let's take a look at these leads. I've got it set on inches right now. We'll look at millimeters in a minute. So here we got 12 thousandths, 12 and a half thousandths thickness on that lead. Let's measure this one just to see if they're both the same. I got them all bent up now. Let's see if I can get a flat spot. There we go, 12 thousandths again. And let's look at it in millimeters. I love this caliper because I can just switch it over to millimeters. And 0.32 millimeters. And 0.31 millimeters. Let's look at the fat leads, the high quality leads. Look at these leads are 0.5. And let's turn that into inches for us folks in the United States, 20 thousandths. So 12 to 20, almost double, almost twice as thick. So that's your problem when you're bending these resistor leads over. You got these junk resistors. So what do? Find a source that has high quality leads. And I talk about where if you get lucky, you can get higher quality resistors with the fat leads. I have not seen any blue ones with fat leads, and I can't read the color coding on those blue ones anyway, so I don't use them in hobby work. The beige colored resistors, these little babies, they're plenty good. So that's plenty good for a lot of hobby work. So that's all I use. And if I have to use one of the blue resistors, I barely can read the color code, so I always have to get the ohmmeter out, and that's just too much of a pain in the butt. So I don't ever try to reuse them. Like with my beige colored resistors, I've got a bunch of junk drawers actually, where I just throw the used stuff in here so I can reuse it again later. And I can pick out the beige colored resistors. I can read the color code on those beige ones, but I cannot read the color code on the blue ones, so I just throw the blue ones away. After I've used them once, they're cheap enough where I just buy a bunch of them and then I just toss them. I've actually gotten a refund a couple of times because it was so hard to read the color code. I gave up on the refund and just toss them. Just buy some more if I need them, but I don't use them much. And let's talk about another problem with these junk breadboards. So not only do you have to deal with junky resistors, but you have to deal with defective breadboards too. And like if you're an Arduino hobbyist, or if you try to use anything with header pins on it that are supposed to be centered up on these holes, you can't get Arduinos in these defective boards because the holes are just such garbage. And the problem with these things is, let's see, I think I've got one. Here, let me show you what's on the back of these things. See, these are just rows and rows of female pins. And here's one that I pulled out of there. If I can get the light right here. There's a female pin here, and I pulled it out of one of these Defective breadboards. And hopefully you can see, let me put it in here. I'll just put it up here, and you probably can't see, but I'll try. The receptor is just too thin, and you can't get any resistors or Arduinos in there because they're too narrow, and they actually block these holes. Instead of giving you a nice receptor to stick leads into, these things are so skinny, they're either off center or they're too thin. The receptor, the female portion, is just too thin. You can't get anything in there. So that's the problem with these things. And in the higher quality perf boards, those things are opened up more and allow an easier access when you're sticking leads in there or trying to put your Arduino in the breadboard. So those are the two things that are messing your life up if you're getting those, if you're having problems with squished up resistor leads, or you can't get your Arduino in there, it's the perf board or the resistor leads. It's not you.